Hey guys, Delmond is here.
On this episode of Ghosted, Love Gone Missing, Travis and Rachel are helping Julia figure out why her longtime best friend Delmond cut her out of his life with no warning.
Have you guys known each other since you were kids?
Yeah, I've known him since I was 3, he was 5, so we're a couple years apart.
You would say he's your oldest friend?
Oh yeah. His mom used to babysit me, so we grew up and did everything together. I don't get along with my mom, I don't get along with my sister. He's the only family I have at the end of the day. We'd go on vacations, we'd go to our cottages, and we did girl things even before he came out. That was the first he came out to. He's always been like my sister and everything, so.
All that changed though, on a typically celebratory anniversary.
When was the date of the ghosting?
The date of the ghosting was around November 8th last year. Every year, we decided to go out on his anniversary of him coming out November 8th, 2014. So that way, you know, we could just have a great time and enjoy.
Celebrate.
Yeah, but I was going through a lot with my family, so I wasn't able to make the anniversary party. And I think that's what really took a toll on our friendship. He stopped talking to me after that. You know, that night at the anniversary party, he was posting things on Snapchat and Facebook, and when I seen the Snapchat shortly after, Delmond, he blocked me on there. So,
He saw that you watched his story, and then he immediately blocked you.
Immediately, yeah. So then on Facebook, I don't think he noticed that we were still friends on there, and he posted a video on there saying he was with his real friends, whatever, and I actually have the video if you guys want to see it.
It sounds like a pretty passive-aggressive post.
I'm here with my real friends celebrating me. Celebrating me!
And now that she's 6 months pregnant, Julia is desperate to find out what exactly happened.
I posted about it.
So there is a very, you know, big chance that he saw the post.
Right, and he hasn't reacted. He hasn't called, texted, liked the picture, nothing. And, you know, that's just odd. How can you go knowing someone your whole life and see that you have a nephew on the way and you just don't care?
Julia has one other theory for Dale's disappearance.
It could be because obviously I was spending a lot of time with my ex-boyfriend, Devin. So maybe Delmond was jealous that I was spending more time with him.
Why did y'all break up?
We broke up because Devin was not the normal boyfriend. He was being very manipulative. He was invading my privacy. He was just...
He was an asshole.
Yeah. We broke up right before the anniversary party.
How did Devin and Del interact with each other?
I mean, it seemed like Del, you know, kind of just put up with him.
Equipped with the info from Julia, Travis and Rachel dive into Dale's social media and find a very unexpected comment.
Wait, what's Devin's last name? Is it?
Yeah, I wrote it down on the phone. Devin, you know you can always talk to me, Del.
Can we just pause on the fact that Devin is commenting on Dale's profile, and according to Julia, they just kind of tolerated each other?
After tracking Devin down, things get real. Fast.
Well, you kind of understand the gist of things. Julia reached out to us. We've just been talking to people, trying to figure out what's up.
Okay. Did you guys ever hang out with her friends?
Yeah.
How much time did you spend with all of them?
I mean, I wouldn't say a good amount of time.
Why did y'all break up?
Just, like, honestly, I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
You didn't ask questions? Oh, well, let me back up. Did you not care that you guys broke up?
I mean, I did care because, like, I was fragile at that moment, so... She hurt me when we did part ways. Like, I was left homeless, like, struggling for a job, like, working side jobs here and there.
What about Del?
It was hard for me. So, like, her best friend was Del. I talked to Del. We ended up growing a friendship.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. That's surprising to us because Julia made it seem like you and Del weren't close.
I mean, it is what it is.
The reason why we're asking all these questions, we're on social media. He recently posted something about not having anyone to talk to. We noticed a comment that you wrote, and you said, "I'll always be here for you, Del."
Yeah, because he had my back. When Julia left me high and dry and f***ed me over in the time in need the most, that's what happened. Del was there for me. She wasn't.
Let me ask you this. Are you surprised that Del has ghosted Julia?
No. This is something I know was going to happen.
Why?
Because she used me. So what I did is, like, I talked to Del. I told him what Julia said. I told him the lies and all the Julia was talking. Julia went and talked to him face to face and say, but guess what? She was telling me.
What was some of the that Julia was talking?
I mean, it's not my place to say.
She was talking about Dale.
Yeah. So Julia was talking about Dale and you decided to tell him to get back at Julia? Yeah. They're all two faces. Like, he always posts on social media about being yourself, but in all reality, he's not. The plastic surgery, like everything, come on.
So you think Dell's a hypocrite as well?
Yeah.
Do you take pride or any responsibility in the fact that Dell ghosted Julia?
Revenge is sweet.
Oh man.
Karma's also a bitch.
Like I said, she used me and she basically left me in the time of need when I needed somebody the most. Revenge is sweet, karma's a bitch.
Karma is a bitch.
It happens.
After learning that Travis and Rachel met with Devin, Delmond quickly hits them up and agrees to meet.
Hi, Del. Can we call you Del?
Absolutely. You guys can come in.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Okay. But you guys said you talked to Devin?
So we literally just left Devin.
Okay, what did he say to you?
I don't like him. Let me just start there.
I don't either.
Okay, so that's news to us.
Okay, yeah.
So we brought up Julia. He had a crazy reaction. He essentially admitted to telling you things that Julia said.
What exactly did he tell you guys?
He talked about Julia and the things that she confided to him in private, but he's very outspoken about, you know, how he doesn't like what you put out on social media. He's accused you of getting surgery and all these crazy things.
He didn't mention anything else.
No.
No, he just kept saying revenge is sweet. He said that over and over again. And he was referring to whatever he told you and how it broke up the relationship that you have with Julian.
Can I ask you this? You would consider Julia family, right? And your closest friend before whatever went down. Do you feel like whatever it is that Julia has the right to know from everything that you've been through?
I can't do this. I can't do this.
I will tell you this though, 15-year plus friendship, like you work through that and you get past that. Y'all were family. And I'll be honest with you, she has been miserable for these last 7 months.
Do you know that she's pregnant? You do know.
She said her baby needs to meet his godfather.
There is a bit more, but I don't know if I can, like, really talk about it.
Look, you don't need to tell us. What we will ask is that you find it somewhere in your heart to sit down with her tomorrow. We're gonna be there, you're not gonna be alone.
I'll talk to her.
I think you're making a step in the right direction.
Okay, so since Dell is in, it's time for these two former friends to come face to face.
I just want to say I miss you so much. I love you so much. I'm so sorry for not going to your anniversary party. I was going through so much and you don't understand how hard it was to go through what I was going through with my mom and the breakup.
She's so heartbroken.
I'm 6 months pregnant now. I don't know if you knew, but your nephew's gonna be here in 3 months. I've been doing it all alone. I need to know what I did so wrong. Was it because I was spending more time with Devin? Was it because he was talking about me? Was it because I didn't go to your anniversary party? What did I do? Why did you ghost me?
I didn't know that you were pregnant. I just couldn't face you. It's been so long.
How can you do that to me?
I was upset that you missed my anniversary party.
That's not it.
And Devin reached out to me. He told me all these horrible things that you supposedly said about me. He told me the reason you didn't come to my party was because I'm a terrible friend. He talked about plastic surgery and just all these nasty things. And it really hurt my feelings because you know how much that hurts me. You know how many times a day I get that from people? People call me fake or superficial or... Did you say those things about me?
I never said anything about you to him, Del. Like, why would I do that to you?
I guess I didn't know where to stand because you didn't come to my party, so I wasn't sure if you're mad at me. We weren't really talking. I should have been a better friend.
I would never talk bad about you. You've been my best friend forever. You were never a bad friend.
That's not true. I was a bad friend. The reason I ghosted you after your breakup with Devin. We had sex and we were together for 2 months. He reached out to me. I guess I was a shoulder to cry on. And he seduced me.
I'm so disgusted with you right now. There's so many men in this world, and you choose one piece of shit over me. I've been in your life how long?
Julia, I'm... Julia, he... I was just stupid. I was stupid. Julia, I'm sorry.
I don't care about him. It's the fact, how could you do that? You stopped talking to me over that. I thought I ruined our friendship, and it wasn't me.
Do you know how manipulative he is? Like, I hate him. Honestly, I wouldn't blame him if you didn't forgive me. Because I don't know if I can forgive myself. You did not deserve that, Julia, and I want to be in Memphis's life.
You see the post?
Every single day, Julia, I regret that, and that's something I can't take back.
I don't know what to say. I have to think about what I want to do.
And with that bombshell, these two now have to decide whether they're going to make up or ghost each other for good.
Before you send your final text, you have a chance to get your last words out if there's anything else that you want to say.
I don't know if I could ever look at you the same again. I don't know if I forgive you because the fact that 16 years was worth giving up for someone so temporary. What you did was wrong, and I can't have that happen to me again.
I just want to let you know that I fully take responsibility for what I've done. It was not okay, and I just want you to know that I do love you, and I apologize for all of this. I was wrong.
Please send a final text now.
Del, what did you decide?
I decided to make up. I honestly f***ed up. I don't deserve you. I really don't. And I'm gonna do everything in my power to make it up to you. I'm gonna try to gain your trust back.
Okay, Julia, what did you decide?
I decided to make up. We have so much history, and I won't allow another person to come between us. You're like blood to me. I forgive you. I won't forget what you did. But I'll always love you, and you will always be a part of my life. You'll always be a part of my heart.
Thank you.
I missed you.
I missed you too. Oh,
it's so nice to see you.
Now that some time has passed, it's time to find out if things are still cool between Julia and Dev.
Hi!
Guys,
what's going on?
Wow. We're happy and we made up. I'm so thankful for you guys bringing my best friend back.
Oh my God.
Now my son has his godfather.
Just to address the elephant in the room, have you guys spoke to Devin? Have you guys been in contact or is he cut? Is he canceled?
No.
Absolutely
no,
not.
No, he's blocked.
On everything.
Good.
Good.
I'm glad we could bring you guys back together.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, that's why we do this.
I know.